I'm Dr. Mark Keller. We'll be talking about sciatic nerve tension. We're going to go over how to assess sciatic nerve tension and how the patient can self-treat with gliding and tensioning sciatic nerve tension. So when we assess sciatic nerve tension, the sitting position gives us great leverage and great variability. Butler of the Neuroorthopedic Institute calls this the sitting slump test. As we raise his leg, we're going to see, is there tension? If he slumps more, that increases the tension. If he brings his head forward, that increases the tension. If he leans back and arches, if he tips his head back, that decreases the tension. That's pretty much the basics of it. We can add dorsiflexion of the foot to add a little bit more tension in that position. The second positioning is with him lying down on his back. And with that one, we're doing the classic Lesage straight leg raise. We're raising his leg up and seeing where the tension starts to build. What you're looking for is tension or heaviness in the leg and or a reproduction of the symptoms that he has. Is it butt pain? Is it hamstring pain? Oh, it's just tight hamstrings. Well, if at this level he gets tight hamstrings on this side, and on the other side he goes all the way up to 80 degrees, it's not just the hamstrings. It means it's something different. So, again, to fine-tune this test, we take it up to the tension point, we dorsiflex the foot, see if that increases the symptoms. We adduct the leg, see if that increases the symptoms. We can also lift his head. I don't know if you can see that. That increases the symptoms. These are various ways of increasing the tension on the dura and seeing if this reproduces the symptoms or comes up with something similar that tells us there is a nerve tension component here. How can the patient release their own nerve tension? Again, David Butler of NOI talks about gliders and he talks about tensioners. These are ways to release that nerve. A glider just glides the nerve back and forth within its tight encasement. A tensioner puts more tension on it. The sitting version of the glider, he puts his hand behind himself, and as he lifts his own leg, he leans back, keeping the lordosis. Then he comes forward and back, and he shouldn't feel any tension or pain. He shouldn't be reproducing his pain doing this. Okay? It's pretty straightforward and simple. As he leans back, he's taking pressure off the dura, but he's bringing his leg up, that's increasing it on the opposite side. The next tool is for him to lie down. He brings his leg up, grabs behind it, and he lifts and lets it down, and lifts and lets it down. He goes right to the point of tension, and then he backs off. He doesn't want to hold there. That could create inflammation. We can add to the tension by dorsiflexing the foot, add to the tension by adducting the leg slightly, and now we're getting a stronger tension. Another thing to do is to have a fulcrum at the point in the lumbar spine where the tension is greatest. An example of this would be, it's going to not be very visible, but if I put my hand, lean toward me, if I put my hand right on his spinous process on this side, on the right side of his spine, I pull on that and now he does the same thing. And he can do that at home with something like a hacky sack or a small soft ball. And now he's fulcruming, so he's focusing that tension of the dura into the area below the point that you're fulcruming. Find the point of tension and fulcrum from there.